Welcome to a second video on solving exponential equations. In this video, we'll discuss how to solve exponential equations that do require using logarithms. And we'll also show how to check them graphically. So here are the general steps that we'll take to solve this type of equation. We'll isolate the exponential part of the equation. If there are two exponential parts, we'll put one on each side of the equation. And then we'll take either the common log or the natural log of both sides of the equation. And we'll use either of these two logs because those are the logs that are on the calculator. And then we'll solve for the variable and check our solutions. So for number one, we need to isolate 7 to the power of x. So we'll add 1 to both sides of the equation. So we'll give us 7 to the power of x equals 5. We obviously cannot get a common base here, so what we'll do now is take the log of both sides of the equation. I'm going to take the natural log. So if we take the natural log of 7 to the power of x, that must equal the natural log of 5. Now what we can do is apply the power property to this log, so we can take this exponent and make it a product of x times natural log 7. So x times natural log 7 equals natural log 5, and now we can divide both sides by natural log 7. So this quotient will give us the approximate value of x. Let's go ahead and get our calculators out. So we have natural log 5 divided by natural log 7. So if we round to the hundredths, this will be approximately 0.83. Now for this problem, I'm going to show one alternative method that we could have used. If you look at the equation in this form, 7 to the power of x equals 5. If we rewrote this as a logarithmic equation, we would have log, the base is 7, the exponent is x, so the log would equal x, and 5 would be the number or the argument of the log. In this form, we could apply the change of base formula so that x would be equal to the natural log of 5 divided by the natural log of the base 7, and what you'll notice is that this quotient here is the same quotient we used to solve for x on the left. This technique only works when you have one exponential part. So we're going to go ahead and show all the problems using the steps outlined here on the left. Also, if we wanted to check this on the graphing calculator, what we could do is type the left side into y1 and the right side into y2 and look for the x-coordinate of the point of intersection. Let's go ahead and try it on this one. So y1 will be 7 to the power of x minus 1, and then y2 will be 4. Press graph. Now notice how my window is not the standard window, so the way to get it back is just to press zoom 6. There's the exponential, and there's the horizontal line. We want the x-coordinate of this point, so we can press second trace, option 5, and then we can just press enter 3 times, 1, 2, 3, and this verifies our solution as x is approximately 0.83. So all of these can be checked graphically as well. Okay, on number 2, we need to isolate the exponential part, or 2 to the power of x. So we'll first add 2 to both sides. That would give us 3 times 2 to the power of x equals 15. And then we'll divide both sides by 3. So we have 2 to the power of x equals 5. Now that we have the exponential part isolated, we'll take the natural log of both sides. So we'll have the natural log of 2 to the power of x equals the natural log of 5. Now we'll apply the power property of log, so we can take this exponent and multiply it by natural log 2. So we have x natural log 2 equals natural log 5. And now we can divide both sides by natural log 2. And so we'll have x is approximately equal to this quotient, natural log 5 divided by natural log 2, approximately 2.32. This does check, but if we wanted to, we could check it graphically. The only concern I see here is that y2 would equal 13. We would have to adjust the window to see that horizontal line. Let's go ahead and do another example, though. So on this problem, we do have two exponential parts. So we have one on each side. So from here, we'll take the natural log of both sides. Well, the natural log 2/3 to the x equals the natural log 5 to the power of 3 minus x. Now we'll apply the power property, which means we can take these exponents, move them to the front. So we'll have x natural log 2/3 equals 3 minus x times natural log 5. Now we'll distribute this natural log 5. So we'll have 3 natural log 5 minus x natural log 5. Now notice we have two terms that involve x. So we're going to go ahead and add x natural log 5 to both sides of the equation. So if we do that, we'll have x natural log 2 thirds. We move this over, it's going to be plus x natural log 5 equals 3 natural log 5. Now we can factor out the common factor of x. And now we can divide by this sum to solve for x. So to determine our solution, we'll have to evaluate this on the graphing calculator. When we enter this into the calculator, though, we're going to have a set of parentheses for the numerator and another set for the denominator to make sure we evaluate this quotient correctly. So we'll have, in the numerator, 3 natural log 5 divided by, and then our denominator will be natural log 2 thirds plus natural log 5. And then another closed parenthesis for our denominator. So it's approximately 4.01. Let's go ahead and check this graphically as well. For the sake of time, I've already entered in the left side in Y1 and the right side in Y2. Let's go ahead and press zoom 6 for the standard window. We're looking for the x-coordinate of the point of intersection. And there it is. What we can do now is just press second trace option 5 and then press enter 3 times. And you can see that does verify our solution. Okay, let's see if we have time for one more. We have two exponential parts. We have one on each side. So we can go ahead and take the log of both sides. I'm going to go ahead and take the natural log again. Now we'll apply the power property so we can take these exponents and make this into a product. So we'll have x minus 3 times natural log 5 must equal 2x plus 1 times natural log 3. Now we'll go ahead and distribute the natural logs. We'll have x natural log 5 minus 3 natural log 5 equals 2x natural log 3 plus natural log 3. We have two x terms, so let's go ahead and put the x terms on the same side, and we'll put the constants on the other side. So we'll move the variable terms to the left side, so we'll have x natural log 5. If we move this term over, it's going to be minus 2x natural log 3 equals, and then if we move this term to the right side, it'll become positive 3 natural log 5 plus the natural log 3 that's already there. Now we'll factor out the x. And our last step is to divide by this difference. Notice on the right side now we just have x. And it'll be approximately equal to, again, this quotient. Let's go back to our calculator and see if we can evaluate this. Our numerator is going to be 3 natural log 5 plus natural log 3. Divided by this difference, so we have natural log 5 minus 2 natural log 3. Enter. Approximately negative 10.1. This one was a lot of work. Let's go ahead and check this just by substituting x into the original equation. So on the right side, we'd have 5 the power of negative 10.1 minus 3. And on the right side, we'd have 3 to the power of 2 times negative 10.1 plus 1. And it's a little bit off because we did round, but that looks very close. So that would verify our solution. Okay, I hope you found these explanations helpful. Thank you for watching.